Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning channel. In this video, we'll conclude the round-tripping workflow between Flame and a 3D application. Originally, you imported a 3D scene into Flame and made some changes. The Action 3D composite was exported out as an FBX and imported into Autodesk Maya for further tweaking and refinement. Finally, you re-exported the FBX out of Maya, and this will be re-imported in Flame to continue the job. If you would like to follow along, please go to part 1 to download the media and follow the steps in part 1 and part 2 to get to this point. In the batch schematic, drag out another action node from the batch node bin. Double-click on the node for its controls, and switch to the node preferences. Ensure the color management has been defined as Scene Linear Rec 709 sRGB. We want to keep the pipeline linear to manage the data. Ensure you are looking at a two-up view with the action schematic and the result view. Now call up the contextual menu and choose Import. Navigate to the FBX file that was exported out of Autodesk Maya. Select the file and disable AutoFit in Scene. If you don't do this, the scene scaling might be incorrect and not match the original action composite. Also note that the FBX will be using the Scene Linear Rec 709 sRGB color space, ensuring the color data has been maintained during the round tripping. Press Load. Firstly, you'll need to look through the right camera. Pan the action schematic and locate the camera node called Main. Double-click the node for its controls and set the result camera to Main 1. Next, you need to reapply the image-based lighting, since IBLs are not part of the FBX round tripping. Ensure the camera is selected and call up the contextual menu. Choose Add Node and select IBL. The IBL is assigned to the media in the media list, but that's not the right image source. Switch to the IBL's Read File menu and press Load. Throughout the entire pipeline, you have been using the Stingray Skydome HDRI. Select the OpenEXR and load it into the node. Now in part 1, you increased the gain of the IBL to 400, and you need to switch to the controls menu and set the same value. So that's the main camera and lighting, but there are still a few more things to review. Let's take a look at the materials on the 3D objects. Panning the schematic, the maps that were originally baked in Flame and then used in Maya have also followed the round trip back to Flame via the FBX. By keeping the color pipeline set to linear, the color values should be the same. However, like in Maya, these textures are permanent. If you wanted to tweak them procedurally, you can just delete these maps and reapply the substance PBR. For example, delete the material node and its associated maps for the 3D lettering. Don't forget to also delete the associated shader node. Select one of the 3D letters and call up the contextual menu. Apply a substance PBR to the selected node. In the browser, navigate to the metal folder and choose Metal Steel Bumped. The substance PBR is now assigned to the selected letter. To apply the same substance PBR to the other two 3D letters, hold Shift Alt and reverse parent the material node to the geometry nodes. Next, take the shader node and hold Shift L to create a light link to the same geometry nodes. So the same material is now applied procedurally to the geometry. And if you call up the Substance Node Advanced Menus, you can increase the bumps, rust, scratches, and dirt to your liking. You can even try different substance PBRs if you're experimenting. Now, panning the action schematic over to the left, you should see a black image object, which is textured by a diffuse map. This is the still reference background that was originally sent to Maya from Flame. You need to replace this with the original moving clip. So hold Alt and double-click on the diffuse map to show its location in the media list. The entry is automatically selected, and you can click the Extract button to push it out to the batch schematic as a node input. Swiping back to the batch flow graph, you can see the image is attached to media input 1. Delete the reference clips and reattach the background movie file into the front input of the media node. Double-click the action node to return to the controls and the 2-up view. You can delete the diffuse map and its texture, as you won't need the reference anymore. Select the black image object and call up the contextual menu. In the Assign Media menu, choose the background clip. So this 3D composite has done a round trip between Flame and Maya, and most of the metadata is still intact. You did replace a material, only to give you the flexibility of the substance PBR, but otherwise, it should be more or less the same. If you hover over the action schematic and press Escape for the batch flow graph, you can toggle between the different action nodes and see a before and after using the 3D interop workflow. You can now continue to use all the features and functionality in Flame to finish the composite. To conclude this video, there are plenty of uses for this round-tripping workflow. It could be mocking things up in Flame for 3D, or refining 3D geometry to make it work even better in Flame. Either way, the FBX interchange format contains most of the metadata, and this workflow is not 3D application specific. This concludes the 3D interop workflow between Flame and other 3D applications. Don't forget to also check out the other workflows, features, and enhancements to the Flame 2018.3 update. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos.